a pretty simple layer. I do recommend wiping down and picking off all the things that you can find before starting this layer. I already wiped mine down to save some time. So just like the last two molting layers, we're gonna need a sponge. I'm gonna put it over there so I can mix. Oh, pretty sure you guys noticed that this is a new, different sculpt. This is Angelica by Alejandra D. Zunga. She is a dream, she's beautiful. Absolutely love her. So I got her to the point that we're at for classes so I don't have to make customs wait longer. All right, so you're gonna need a sponge and you're gonna need your thing. You're gonna need your psycho paint. And as for colors, we're just gonna play it by ear with what happens. I'm gonna go ahead and make my sponge, just like we did for the purple and blue, purple molting. We're gonna be doing the same thing. I'm sure you guys are wondering about blue molting also. Okay, well, blue molting, I like it. I feel like it is very prominent on silicones. So I like to do more of a blue undertone. Everyone is different. You might end up attempting to do blue molting and love it. That's great. You're allowed to do that. But this is how I do mine. I do heavy blue undertones in special spots. It just, in my opinion, gives more of a realistic appearance once matted. Because you gotta realize, like, what you're seeing while it's shiny versus what it looks like when it's matted, two totally different things. Just making a molting sponge to have it ready. You're gonna need a plate. You're gonna need Mona Lisa mineral spirits, paint thinner, whatever you wanna call it. You're gonna need lots of colors that we will work on together figuring out what we want. You know, keep in mind that most babies, like, that I make can never be recreated. Because the colors, like, I use different colors for every baby. I let the blank just kind of tell me what it needs to do. And you follow the directions of what it tells you. Alright, so you're gonna grab your B. And your toothpicks. I'm gonna put your part B down. Close lid. Grab an equal amount of part A. let's start off with pale pink. See a little better. Let's do 2 drops. Definitely gonna need your silk pig. I'm going to use about this much focus. You get the idea. Put that in. Mineral spirits. We're gonna make this very thin like we did with the purple. I don't know why I always mix up so much. So much leftover. Because I like to waste product. I guess like you'd rather have more than not enough. Because, you know, like I said, I can't ever recreate. The only thing that I write down is the skin tones. Other, you know, skin tone layers. Other than that, like, I just wing it, so I can't recreate it. You definitely want all of the front to look the same. Let's grab some 12. I'm gonna grab some 12, which is also known as plum. Come on, open without being a big mess. Never.
Never.
Can never. So that wipe that you use to wipe down your baby, keep it around. I'm gonna use about that much. All right, we're going to use some vibrant rose. There's about that much. Just dip it in there. You know, nothing measured. I meant to do that. I live for the mess of silicone. All right, that looks pretty nice to me. You're gonna take your plate. And you're just gonna dump it all onto your plate. All right, now is the time to like work on the lips. Like if you feel like it is not at a desired tone that you like, then go ahead and add some of this to the lips. I personally like the color that the lips are right now at this given second. Don't think I want to add any more to it. We'll see what it looks like after we put down like lots of skin layers for me. But if you want to now, you can. Okay. All right, I'm gonna try to make this close so you guys can see like over in this direction. This is what I'm doing. So I'm taking a little and I'm dabbing all of that excess off. You don't want big clumps of matting. You don't want big clumps of malting on your baby. You want it to be very consistent. Alright, so I always start at the top of the head, like right around the soft spot, and I just stamp it. Okay, load it back up, dab it off, and do the same thing. You just light on for you guys. I can work in the dark. Don't worry about me. I want you guys to see. The light is making a glare that you guys can't see. See, you don't want that. You don't want a big glob. Yeah, time to wipe it off. Behind the ear, work your way to the front. Around the cheeks. And I start going under the neck. Make sure that it stays nice and consistent. You don't want like little globs of it. You just want it to lay the color down. This is a fairly fast layer. Remember what I said before, like after the creasing and the blushing and it's all smooth sailing, and being that you did the front and the back of blushing and creasing of the hands, it's gonna be a million times easier. It's gonna be a million times easier when we go to flip her over. All right, so you're avoiding the nose. You're avoiding the lip, the up top of the lip. Everything else is fair game. All right, so I start in the middle. So you don't want anything to be like too repetitive. So like move your sponge around in different directions, and you don't want the pattern to be like, well, that's definitely a stamped on area. You know, you want it to be very natural and random. You guys could see like how this area over here, it hasn't had molting yet. So this is when the baby starts to really like, you see life in it. I mean, technically, depending on what the baby's poured in, this could be the end of the day. You know, like you could literally, at this point, if you wanted, you could go ahead and seal the mat. That's not what I do, but that's what you could do. Especially with Alejandro's babies, like they're poured in such a natural tone. Make sure that you get there. So we're just putting paint on what we could see. If you have a hard time seeing the back of the leg or the other side of the leg, do not attempt to paint that side of the leg, because 9 times out of 10, there's going to be like runoff paint or something that happens doing that. Don't forget that we have to flip it over and do all of this again. We'll go ahead and do the top of the feet. And the bottom of the feet to a certain extent. If any of you guys have started your silicones, I'd be very, very excited to see how they're turning out so far. And also get some feedback of, like, you know, what else would you like to learn, or what do you need like more tutorials on? Did I not explain something good enough? Move over to the arms. I'm gonna try to post another video next week, and like I mean this week, like probably by Friday, of like the skin layers. See, double check. Yeah, I'm over here painting in the dark, so don't sit here and judge. I'm just saying, painting in the dark so you guys could see better. But I'm gonna post another video probably on Friday if I can. Of skin layers. Okay, my friends, that is how you do the molting layer, the red molting layer. After that, you just let this cure for a million years. It's probably gonna take about 3 hours to cure. Let this cure for about 3 hours. And then you can do your next layer. All right, guys, you have a good day. Bye.